Hi guys, and welcome back. It's only been a day or so after the Virginia election, and yes, we are already here. This is the 2024 presidential election between the Republican Glenn Youngkin and the Democrat Kamala Harris. I choose Harris because she is not your generic Democrat, but she's a very unlikable but a very likely nominee in 2024 since Biden is so old and frail. And Youngkin just won the governorship in Virginia, so I definitely think that he is an interesting candidate to look into. So I wanted to make this video so we could talk a little bit about where he would perform strongly, what would be his strengths, and how would he deal against, well, not a generic Democrat, but someone who probably represents the party leadership very much at this moment. So of course he is going to win the safe Republican states, and the coastal areas are going to be quite safe as well for Harris. And already now I think we're starting to see that Youngkin's appeal in suburban areas are pushing down the margins, and I think it could be, well, actually below 10 points in New Jersey, below 10 in Oregon, and in other places where you would expect him to do well. Virginia, I think, would still go Democratic, but it would be very close. I mean, we're still talking presidential year turnout, so I don't think Youngkin would overcome it, even though he might get as much as 2 million votes in the state. The Democratic ground game in Virginia is just really good in a presidential election year. So you never know, and he would also have to appeal a bit more to conservatives and the mainstream of the Republican Party in order to win on a national scale. So that can be taken into account. Texas, I think, would go likely. I mean, he would probably win back Tarrant County. He would do better in the suburbs also in Texas. He is not Trump, and he's quite different. I know I didn't talk much about running mates here, but we're just going to keep them out for the sake of this video. I think also Youngkin would win back the state of Arizona. I mean, I could definitely see Maricopa County flip back to the Republicans for the sake of this. And we can say the same about Georgia. I don't think that his strong showings among suburban voters and even among black voters would fade away just because he ran in a presidential election. Yes, maybe enough to lose Virginia, which is quite blue, but not Georgia, which has just become purple. And then we go on to North Carolina, which I believe also would be in that category. North Carolina is more of a Trump state. Republicans there have been very much supportive of Trump. If you see how Georgia and North Carolina both moved from 2012 to 2016 to 2020, North Carolina was much more of a Trumpian area. And let's now take a look at where we can give Harris these areas, because now we are going to the Rust Belt. And the thing is, this depends a lot on what are the approval ratings of Biden at this time, how is the economy. But I'm just going to assume that the economy is okay, not terrible, not great. It's more likely to be terrible, but we're going to get on with this and say that Youngkin is probably just going to win New Hampshire by a narrow margin. Harris might still win Maine at large, but Youngkin is probably going to win Maine second quite easily. I mean, Trump won there by 10 in 2016. Youngkin, he has proven that he's quite strong in the rural areas still. So in Nebraska second, I think he could win that back, and he would probably also win Iowa and Ohio. Not that he is the perfect fit for these states, but he's definitely a better fit than Harris. And yeah, it is already looking quite much like he is going to win. But he has run a quite local campaign, so I don't know how he would appeal to voters in states far, far away. States like Nevada. They have quite different issues in Nevada than they have in Virginia. But the state has been trending Republican, and I think that he would win there. I know that he would probably have to deal with the re-election of Jackie Rosen or helping to take her down. In Arizona, there would be a lot of Sinema Youngkin voters in Maricopa County. And the five states that remain are all swing states, well, except from Florida, which would be quite solid for Youngkin. Depends on his running mate. I mean, if he took Marco Rubio, it would be very easy to win Florida. And then we have the Rust Belt. Now, Wisconsin and Pennsylvania, I think we both go to Youngkin. Okay, maybe even stronger in Wisconsin. Michigan, it really depends on the economy. But I do think that the economy would have to be very good for Harris to win, because she would really rely on very heavy turnout in Detroit and in Ann Arbor, and I don't think that would be possible. I also think that Youngkin will win back Kent County, which is Grand Rapids. So yeah, going in there. And Minnesota, we could give this to Harris, but I just don't think that she would win there either. I mean, yes, no Republican has won there since 1972, but it has been closed a few times. 84 it was close, in 2016 it was close. And if the Democrats nominate a bad enough candidate, it certainly could flip. So now we are at 327 for Youngkin, 211 for Harris. I think that's quite reasonable. Certainly against a better Democrat, he could do much worse in the Rust Belt, but I still think that he would do quite strongly in the South and the Sun Belt compared to someone like Trump. But thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.